Braamfontein Cemetery is one of the oldest in Johannesburg. In fact, it's over 100 years old. And when you walk through here, you can feel and hear the hoofbeats from the horse-drawn carriages that brought the dead to be buried here, followed by the mourners from all different races, creeds and religions, from Dutch Reformed to Roman Catholic, to Jewish, to Muslim and to Hindu. In the far corner of the cemetery is the crematorium for the Hindus that was built in 1932. And the far top corner is the Jewish section, which is completely separate. And the Muslim section. Plus, there's a little mosque there that was built by request from the Malay community that lived in the area just around here. It's in a slight state of disrepair at the moment, but that still doesn't detract from what one feels when you get here. It's really quite a deep feeling of history, a deep feeling of community, of life, what life must have been like. Graves of people that fought for their country or died for their beliefs can be found. This is a memorial to all the proud British soldiers that lie buried in the Braamfontein Cemetery. In the pauper section is where a lot of the miners that were involved in the strike in 1922 are buried, as well as the Foster Gang, who captured the imagination of the public and died in a shootout with the police. The main reason we're here, though, is to visit the gravesite of Enoch Sontonga. In 1994, the National Monuments Commission discovered that this is possibly where the remains of Enoch Sontonga were. The 32-year-old teacher composed Nkosi Sikelel' iAfrika, which in 1994 was also adopted into the official South African anthem. This monument was opened by Nelson Mandela, and Nelson Mandela also honored Enoch Sontonga and naming the road that runs adjacent to the cemetery Enoch Sontonga Road. This whole area is filled with graves of unknown people, miners, people that passed away and were buried in unmarked graves. The sense of history, struggle, sadness, triumph, and peace can be felt when you walk through this sacred ground.